In this lesson, we'll be learning about design and sizes. This feature allows you to configure the size and position of artwork for defined groupings of sizes. To add artworks on different sizes, we first must have a garment that is graded. For this lesson, we are starting with the file that has the avatar size set set up, and the garments in different sizes have all been dressed on the respective avatars. If you would like to learn how to set up avatar size sets, watch the lesson in 301 Avatar and Pattern Shape Functions. We start by assigning an artwork on the base size. Next, we select the artwork in the 2D or 3D window with the Select tool. In the Context view, we click on the Eye icon or View button. The Design and Sizes pane is now displayed at the bottom of the screen. This pane displays all the sizes available, and the artwork is automatically assigned and positioned on the different sizes. In many cases, we would normally have different sized artworks for different sizes of the garment, as the artwork needs to be proportionate to the garment size. This is where we can adjust the sizes of artworks according to the defined group sizes. We can undock the pane. Then click the same icon again to dock the pane. Here we can zoom in and out to have a better view of the artwork on each size. The last icon is to hide or show the rulers of the artwork position on each size. The selected size is highlighted in bright blue and the rest are highlighted in pale blue. The artwork size for the selected size is stated at the bottom. Any changes made to the artwork size and position are automatically reflected on the measurements in the Design and Sizes pane. We can also click on each size and view the artwork on the different sizes. This can be useful for designers to evaluate if the artwork size and placements of each size are proportionate to the garment and if there needs to be any adjustments of the larger and smaller sizes. When working with Design and Sizes, we first need to define or import a grouping of sizes. For example, if size extra small and small are using the same sized artwork, we can group them together. To do so, we hover our cursor over the dot in between S and M, and click on the scissors icon to split the group of sizes. If large and extra large are also using the same size artwork, then we also split medium from large size. Now we can see that extra small and small are in one group, medium is in another, and large and extra large in another group. This means that any changes to artwork size or placement on any size only affect the other sizes within the same group. For instance, if we make changes to the artwork on size small, it only affects the artwork size and placement on extra small, but not for size medium, large, or extra large. If we need to merge the groups of sizes, we can click the arrows displayed when we hover our cursor over this gray dot in between the group sizes. To add or remove sizes to or from a group, we can also drag the vertical handle at the end of the group. Once we set up the defined group of sizes, we can lock or unlock this configuration by clicking the lock icon. This is to help us avoid making any accidental changes to the defined group of sizes. We can also save this as a preset, so we can use this defined group of sizes for other files. If we want to share this preset with other users, we simply export it and send the VStitcher size ranges preset .sdp to other users. To import an existing SDP file, we import it and select the preset we want to use for the garment we are working on. In the preset dropdown, we have the option to automatically make all sizes into one group by clicking Full Size Range. We also have the option to automatically divide every size. This is useful if all garment sizes use different artwork sizing. To delete any presets, we click the X on the row for the grouping we want to delete. Once the defined sizes group is all set up, we are ready to edit and adjust the sizes and placement of the artwork for each size. We can make changes in the 2D or 3D window, and any change is automatically updated in the Design and Sizes pane. Let's adjust the extra small and extra large artwork size and placement. To exit the Design and Sizes pane, we click on the X icon on the top right corner of the pane. And that is how we use Design and Sizes to configure the size and position of artwork for defined grouping of sizes. For more information, visit our Help Center.